Welcome back. We've completed step one by inserting the turnout feedback and defining it and assigning it to each of the turnouts in the structure. Carrying on with the five-step procedure, step two is to group it. Okay. So we know a turnout is never included in a block. So a turnout feedback is also not part of a block. Therefore, we must not group it with a block, which would be an easy mistake to make with a feedback that is next to a block like this. But we can group it with a turnout using the same G technique. So click on the turnout, press G, then click on the feedback, press G again, and then click away and one final G, and we have now grouped that feedback with the turnout. These tracks between turnouts have also been grouped with a turnout. So this one is grouped to that. That one is grouped. And we can see that that one is also grouped. In general, it is better to add the track element to the sharp end of the turnout because the relation is then independent of the state of the turnout. So it is better to group this section of track with this turnout rather than grouping this section of track with this turnout, where there could be two different positions. If it is not possible to group the section of track on the sharp end of the turnout, such as in this example, where the straight section of track is already grouped to another turnout, then it is okay to group the track on the blunt ends. And we do that using the same G technique. But in this case, the sections of track would not actually end up being lilac. They will be a brown colour. But you will only see that on exiting the edit mode and going back into the switchboard, and now we see they are a brown color. These colors are only seen in edit mode and not on the main switchboard. Also, only group a track element to a single turnout. Never try to group two or more turnouts together, because that is not allowed. In a well-defined switchboard in edit mode, it's good practice to group all elements. Any non-grouped elements will stand out because they will be grey if using the dark look of switchboard. If I ungroup these by going Shift G, you see they are showing grey. Or if using the classic or contrast look of switchboard, non-grouped elements are black. It is then easy to identify elements that have not been grouped, and then you can correct them. So that is all for this tutorial. In the next episode, we complete the remaining steps in the process. So until then, bye for now.